Wayland's initial release was back in 2008, 17 years ago. Fedora Workstation began defaulting to Wayland, at least on the AMD side, back in 2016. Now, 2016, Wayland was not ready. Like, nobody besides the biggest Wayland advocates are going to argue that. And Ubuntu tried to follow suit in 17.10 and realized very quickly that, that was the case, it was not ready, and by 18.04, they had reverted back. But that doesn't mean the whole swapping to Wayland thing never happened. They did do that a while ago, they've been defaulting for quite a bit. And about 2 weeks ago, I covered this comment from Jeremy Bicker, where he wasn't exactly sure what Canonical was going to do in regards to GNOME upstream going and dropping the X11 side. Because the initial plan for Ubuntu was in 2604, they would include GNOME X11 alongside the Wayland side, just to have that final LTS release with X11 available. This obviously was creating some tension, some conversation upstream where, you know, you have this giant project that wants to keep shipping X11, but do we hold it back even though we want to get rid of it entirely by that point? What exactly needs to happen here? But it turns out though, there's no need to have any more concerns because they just changed their mind. In Ubuntu 25.10, they'll be dropping GNOME on Xorg. So this is the version that GNOME wants to start disabling the X11 side. The code's still gonna be there. They won't have stripped everything out yet, but that's basically the ending point where they wanna say no more X11 in GNOME going forward. If you're still using it, you better stop doing so. And if you don't wanna stop doing so, well, I guess a fork is in order. See where that takes you. Now, just so we're clear, 25.10 is questing Quokka. Quokka is how you say it. Not questing Cocker. You could very well mistakenly read it like that if you're very internet-brained like I am. Starting with this release, the Ubuntu session in GDM will run exclusively on Wayland. So I believe as of 24.10, so the release the year prior, that is when, across everything on Ubuntu GNOME, they were defaulting to Wayland, so both AMD and NVIDIA. AMD was done quite a bit earlier, but NVIDIA 24.10. So by this point, there'll be a couple of cycles in, there'll be plenty of time to deal with problems, and they do address the idea of NVIDIA users still having problems on Ubuntu today, and the problem does actually make quite a bit of sense. So for the majority of people, this change isn't going to affect anything. The majority of people on Ubuntu GNOME were already using Wayland. And if you weren't using Wayland, it's very likely you probably weren't using the main version of Ubuntu anyway. You're probably on one of the other flavors or one of the very few people actually still using X11 GNOME. Now, why are they making the change? No, it has nothing to do with Ex Libre. It's not because Ex Libre suddenly was created and they're terrified of Ex Libre. Oh my god, we have to put a stop to Ex Libre as quickly as possible. No, that's obviously not the case. And if you watched any of the videos on this channel, you would know that's not the case because you would know the whole move to Wayland has been a work in progress for many years now. Over the past several cycles, the Wayland experience has matured significantly, including improved support for NVIDIA drivers, offering a more robust security model, stable support for most daily workflows, better graphic stack isolation, and improved touch and high DPI support. Now, there is more on the NVIDIA stuff, but do note with the NVIDIA stuff, if you have a card older than the 10 series, most of those improvements are not going to affect you. This is a problem where it's basically dealt with in the modern NVIDIA cards, but the modern NVIDIA cards are expensive and a lot of people don't have the modern NVIDIA cards, so they still have the problems. Meanwhile, maintaining both X11 and Wayland sessions introduces technical debt and increase in maintenance burden, limiting our ability to innovate efficiently. And considering that upstream, like in the KDE case, doesn't really care about the X11 side, basically the only patches you're getting are sort of incidental patches. GNOME wants to strip out the X11 side entirely. They're not like doing serious development work there. So basically the only things that get improved are things that happen to affect both sides. And GNOME's planning to remove Xorg support for GNOME 49. That would be the next release of GNOME. So we'll see if that happens. That is like their current go-to plan. It was GNOME 50 originally. Now the plan is to start stripping the code out in GNOME 50, but remove the ability to run the Xorg side in GNOME 49. We are taking a proactive step in 25.10 to prepare our users and ecosystem ahead of that deadline. Whilst Upstream is removing the ability to have the X11 side in GNOME 49, the code's still gonna be there, so it can still be brought back. So why bother doing it in 25.10? Why not do it alongside the next LTS, 26.04? By moving now, we give developers and users a full cycle to adapt before the next LTS, align with GNOME 49, and reduce fragmentation while simplifying our support matrix heading into the LTS. Basically, they want to make sure that things are actually in a good state by having a 6-month cycle there where all of their users are making use of it, and hopefully any of those final issues get ironed out before going entirely to the Wayland side. Now, what this means in practice is if you were making use of the X11 session on Ubuntu GNOME, that option's just not going to be there anymore. You will only have that option of Wayland. Now, if you install another desktop like KDE, for example, the X11 side for that is not going away. That is still going to have the X11 session there, as GDM isn't doing away with the ability to launch X11 sessions. That was a discussion that was being had, but they decided maybe it makes sense to keep that around. So that's still going to work. It's just only on GNOME, the X11 side will be gone. Again, it's not going to affect most people though, as most people are on the Wayland side. If you are someone who does require the use of X11, whether that be for some general functionality, for some accessibility stuff that might not be entirely there on the Wayland side just yet, there are obviously other flavors available. As I stated before, KDE right here with Kubuntu does still have the X11 side. There's still some stuff in Upstream KDE they need to deal with to firstly make that really viable to get rid of the X11 side, but secondly, to deal with some problems that they want to have resolved before they go entirely Wayland. KDE is being a lot more conservative here and willing to keep the X11 side around a bit longer as they iron out everything that needs to be ironed out to make the experience as good as possible, rather than sort of jumping the gun a bit when it's mostly there. Now, besides the obvious changes, there are some more subtle ones being made as well. One example being, where is the Xorg server package going to live? So, previously, being something used in the main version of Ubuntu, this was in the main repos. With that not being the case anymore, it makes sense to move it over to Universe, the place where it's basically like the extra packages for Ubuntu. It's basically like the extra repo on something like Arch. And the answer to that is, yeah, that's where it's moving. Does this affect you as a user? No, because you can still just download the package without even really thinking about it. This is more of a sort of management side and something the flavors need to think about, as opposed to you as just a regular person on the distro. Now, the more substantial thing is from the NVIDIA users. I've seen concerns from NVIDIA users a couple of times recently, so want to add some detail about that. Most users of Ubuntu with NVIDIA hardware seem to be running a 24.04, that being the LTS, just like most users of Ubuntu itself. As such, they will not have noticed all the stabilization work that went into making Wayland the default for NVIDIA in 24.10, and as of right now, in June 2025, the list of unsolved issues on NVIDIA is tiny. Now, keep in mind, these are the unsolved reported issues, right now being 5. Wasn't this 4 yesterday? Maybe I just can't count. I thought, whatever. There's 5 things on the list. There might be other things, and if there are, and you know of something that might not be addressed here, please do go and report it, because that's the only way that anyone's going to find out about it. And NVIDIA itself has a list of features. I believe I did a video on the first one of these posts that are not yet available, but we don't expect most desktop users to be concerned with those, especially a year from now, which is the soonest most Ubuntu users will experience the removal of Xorg. So it's happening in 25.10, but most people in Ubuntu are on the LTS release, so they won't even experience it. until 2604 anyway. Now, of course, because this got shared around in the context of Ex Libre and all that stuff that was going on, there was this mod right here who had to step in, put things on slow mode. One post ended up being deleted because people can't, you know, have their crazy conspiracies on Twitter or Reddit or other places. They had to like bring it into the official forum. Don't do that. If you want to see some crazy shit in my comment section, hey, go right ahead. Fully support it. It's great for the algorithm. But don't go and do it in some project like this. That's weird. That's cringe. And you're just going to get banned. And I'm going to laugh at you when it happens. Now, I know that Ubuntu isn't really known for making radical changes. Unless they made the radical change themselves. In which case, you have Mia. You have Snaps. But when it comes to, like, other things that other people do, they tend to be fairly slow in adopting them. Even so, Fedora defaulted to Wayland a long, long time ago, at least on the AMD side, back 8 years ago. The KDE side, they did a bit more recently. NVIDIA side on both GNOME and KDE a bit more recently as well. But even so, like, they've done it for a really long time. But with Ubuntu here, we're basically waiting until the very last second to say, okay, you know what? I guess it's time to actually go and do this Wayland thing and only have the Wayland thing. Again, they were defaulting for a while, but to actually get rid of the X11 side, like, they're basically waiting until the final release of GNOME to do so. Now, in other semi-related news, I have a very similar post about Manjaro as well. Manjaro KDE Plasma is planned to move to Wayland. Now, they're not dropping the X11 side here. They are defaulting to Wayland. So, upstream KDE, they have been defaulting to Wayland since the launch of 6.0. That was about 2 years ago now. And other distros like Fedora were defaulting various other times. Ubuntu, Kubuntu, various other times. I think they might have started with 6.0 as well. I didn't even realize Manjaro wasn't defaulting to the Wayland side. I don't know why they weren't. I don't know what reason they had. Like, it makes sense to not try and get rid of the X11 side. Totally understandable. But why would you change that default? I do get changing the default in the case of NVIDIA cards. That makes sense. I get that. But the AMD side, I don't know the reason for this. But anyway, I didn't want to make a full video on this because it's basically the exact same topic just done again from the Manjaro side. So, hey, yeah, I guess Manjaro is also defaulting as well, even though they should have been doing so years ago, and whatever. Anyway, Ubuntu, at least the GNOME side, going full Wayland. What are your thoughts? Do you happen to use the X11 side still? Do you maybe use another flavor and don't really care what mainline Ubuntu does? Or maybe use something like Fedora and think they should have done so earlier? Or maybe you think Fedora did so too early? I would love to know. So if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LiberaPay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and next year, Wayland can drink. Unless it's in America, because drinking age is 21. But it can vote. Yeah, it can vote. That's what it can do. What is this?